Hey everybody, Nice Link here, back with another episode of Legend Elza. Legend da 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 da. Up to a wonderful start. Well, we say, as you see here, we saved the forest. Now all the little children are out playing again and humping rocks and doing other Kakirish things, I guess. Oh well. Okay, what do I want to do next? I honestly don't even know. Could go do that. Yeah, let's go do that. Let's go back to the Temple of Time. We're going to learn. I thought my horse was here. Get her out of this corner. Head back to the Temple of Time. We can go ahead and learn a valuable song in the game. You don't have to get this yet. You don't need it until after you beat the next dungeon, but it's available to us now, so I figured why not go ahead and get it. This place is so creepy. All these re-deads, man. Re-deads are creepy in every Zelda game they are in, I swear. Not a lot of things creep me out, but re-deads is one of the very few things that does. So let's head back in here to where we got the Master Sword. Activate this cutscene. You destroyed the wicked creatures that haunted the temple and awakened the sage. But there are still other sages who need your help. In order to awaken all the other sages, you must become even more powerful. You must travel over mountains, underwater, and even through time. If you want to return to your original time, return the Master Sword to the Pedestal of Time. By doing this, you will travel back in time 7 years. The time will come when you will have to return here quickly. I will teach this to you for when that time comes. The song to return you to the Temple of Time, the Prelude of Light. This is a really pretty song. Whoops. I'm hitting up. Can I not get out of this so I can... There we go. I don't know why I was hitting up. I even watched myself hit it. That was strange. Oh well. Let's Players Curses. Gotta love it. So there we go. Now we have the ability to travel back and forth in time. So if we want to become a kid again, all we gotta do is put the sword back in its pedestal and, you know. There we have it. Right now, there's not really any need to go do that. Did I get Song of Storms yet? Yeah, there's no need to go do that yet, so. How many? I need two more Skulltulas. There's one close by here we can get, actually. so I'm going to go ahead and go grab it. And another cutscene ensues. Man, look at this place. Ganon really knows how to redecorate, doesn't he? Though I do have to admit, his tower looks pretty freaking awesome compared to Hyrule Castle. I always thought Hyrule Castle in this game was kind of just... I don't know, I never was all that impressed with it. Just seemed like kind of a generic castle to me. Like, Peach's castle in Mario 64 looked really good. And, they pretty much still use that design to this day for her castle. Should be... There he is. There we go. And let's go find one more of those. Yeah, this place is pretty morbid, and you can pretty much probably use your imagination of what those skeletal remains once belonged to. I'm assuming one of the guards that used to stand around here. And I don't even want to know where these re-dead spawned from and what they were created from. Trying to think where I can get a Skulltula. Did that moon just go down and come back up, or was it just me? That seemed odd. There might be one here. Let me turn my sound up so I can hear these things. Okay. I think there's one in the graveyard. One that we couldn't reach as a kid. I think I remember pointing it out to you guys when we were here for the first time. It might be up here. Let's kill this jerk real quick. You can capture those in bottles. And there's a Poe... like collector that lives right as you go into Hyrule Castle, you can sell them to. I think it gives you like 10 rupees for these Poes here. I could swear that there's a Skulltula here. I swear it's like right over here too. Well, I'll be damned. It is night, right? Whoops. Not one behind here, is there? I could have sworn there was a... Oh well. I just wasted my time and yours. Anyways, let's just go ahead and head up here. That little guy you saw back there, if you have a fish in a bottle, he'll give you 200 rupees for it. And that's a real good, easy way to build your rupees up if you need it for whatever. I can't think of, at this point in the game, what you would need 200 rupees for, to be honest. So now we're headed up here again. Things have changed a little. We've got to deal with these giant boulders rolling down toward us. Ow. I'm going to try something here. Also, if you bomb that, there's 50 rupees in there. I'm not going to worry about that right now. Yeah, I know, Nabby. I know. I'm going to try. I couldn't do this with the other controller. Wait a minute. I hear it. Can I bomb you? Are you bombable? Nope, but I killed it. Can't get it though. Okay, let's see if we can do this. Yeah, yeah, we got up here. Get our heart piece right here. That's actually not the way you're supposed to get that. What you're supposed to do is plant a bean, magic bean, in a spot right here as a kid, and when you come here as an adult. There'll be a plant that you can ride up and jump in there and get it, but I did it the super secret awesome way. And we now have more health too, so yay. You know, something I forgot to do is get the bomb upgrade. We could have went back in time and done it too, and I just now remembered it. Maybe a couple episodes from now we'll do it. Let's see what we got going on here. Which floor is this guy on? Right underneath me here. Just missed. So you see this, there's a small Goron running around here. The only way we can stop him is by bombing him. If you don't want to waste your bombs, you can use bomb flowers. Got it. Yeah, there we go. How could you do this to me? You're Ganondorf's servant. Hear my name and tremble. I am Link, hero of the Gorons. What? But I'm Link. What? Your name is also Link? Then you must be the legendary Dodongo Buster and Hero Link. My dad is Darunia. Do you remember him? Dad named me Link after you because you're so brave. It's a cool name. I really like it. Link, you're a hero to us Gorons. I'm so glad to meet you. Please give me your autograph. Oh, God. Sign it to my friend, Link and the Gorons. So, this is Otaku Goron? Oh, I guess it's not a good time to ask you for this. Please help everyone. My dad, Darunia, went to the Fire Temple. A dragon is inside. If we don't hurry up, even my dad will be eaten by the dragon. Boo-hoo! A long time ago, there was an evil dragon named Volvagia living in this mountain. That dragon was very scary. He ate Gorons. Using a huge hammer, the hero of the Gorons, boom! Destroyed it just like that. This is a myth from long ago, but it's true. I know, because my dad is a descendant of the hero. Poo-hoo. Everybody was taken to the fire temple. While my dad was out, Ganondorf's followers came and took them all away. All of them will be eaten by Valvagia. Dad said that that Ganondorf has revived Valvagia. As a warning to those who might oppose him, Ganondorf is going to feed them all to Valvagia. Dad went to the fire temple all by himself to try to save everyone. Please help, Link. I'll give you this heat-resistant tunic. Cool! New clothes! Accessorizing! So now we can go down here. It's kind of funny, of all the Gorons that didn't get abducted, this guy survived. But yeah, his whole race is about to be slaughtered and eaten by a giant dragon, and he's going to charge us for weapons. Why don't we head into Volvagia's room? If you talk to the young Goron again, he'll tip you off that this is here. And before we go in here, you want to equip your awesome new red tunic. And now we're into the Death Mountain Crater. I'm going to run this one a few more minutes, this episode. Shot on over. Hello, Sheik. It is something that grows over time. A true friendship. A feeling in the heart that becomes even stronger over time. The passion of friendship will soon blossom into a righteous power, and through it, you will know which way to go. This song is dedicated to the power of the heart. Listen to the Bolero of Fire. One of the best cutscenes in this entire game. So now we can warp to the Death Mountain Crater anytime we want. Link, I'll see you again. Huh? Whenever you warp, you'll warp right on top of that right there. So let's head in here. Whoops. And here we are. The Fire Temple, which we're going to do next time in the next episode of Ocarina of Time. Thanks, everybody. Have a great day.